My name is Frances, and I'm really excited today to introduce you to Designrr. Designrr is a tool for entrepreneurs, content editors, or anyone who simply wants to create a beautiful ebook in a matter of minutes. So I'm a designer myself, so I really appreciate this tool, how it saves me a lot of time. It saves me from duplicating a lot of efforts. What it does is it reuses the content I already have, which is whether it's a blog post, whether it's Word, PDF, and even a YouTube video. It pulls in my content and generates a beautiful ebook or even a flipbook. And it does it in simply a matter of minutes. I could make global changes right onto the platform. It's a cloud-based platform, which means that there's simply nothing to download. And it's just amazing because I could go in and duplicate my projects and reuse it over and over. You know, I can go on and on about this tool, but I think it's best to show you what it can do and if it's right for you as well. Let's get started. I'll meet you at the dashboard. As I enter the dashboard, you can see that it's a very intuitive, simple dashboard. It has my project, which is list here. I have my draft. And if you ever get stuck, you can go into the help documentation. They also have a wonderful YouTube channel, which I've subscribed to, called Designrr, and it shows you detail step by step on different features if you ever were stuck on it. So let's go back to project here, and you can see you could, as your list grows, you can do sort from oldest A to Z, and you can also search your projects too. So let's get started with creating a new project, and I can show you the types of project you have. And I love how it's step by step. It tells you step one, step two, step three, exactly where you're at. So the first step I would like to do is I started doing YouTube videos 2 weeks ago, demos and review videos like this. Please subscribe if you haven't, I really would appreciate it. So I'm going to take one of my videos and I'm going to have it create a nice publication and a transcript. So I'll take you through the steps. And you could also, of course, pull from your Word, you could pull from your blog, and here you could do a new draft, you can merge, and also show you the features of a flipbook, which I think is more engaging to put on the website or to put on Facebook. So I'm going to take a video, let's say I take this video, and I'm going to copy, Control-C, go back into my dashboard, simply click on this icon here, and then test project 25 or something, and then you have your footer option. Simply copy paste in, and you also have the option here of uploading from a disk. As you see here, all the supported format, in case you forget what you can put in is URL, YouTube, Dropbox, share link, video types, and then even audio. So this is wonderful if you're working with accessibility. I work with federal websites, and they require anytime you have a video creation, you need that caption, you need that transcript to make it 5-week compliant. So this does it in matter of like 3 minutes, 4 minutes. And I think that feature alone, I'm going to really, really enjoy and really awesome. In addition to making a nice published ebook, is just icing on top. So once I click import, you're going to see that it tells you the file name. You could have changed that in the length of your video, and it tells you how long it's going to take to subscribe this, which is 2 minutes. It will email you when it's ready, so you don't have to wait around. You know exactly what you have, and then you have your subscription, how much time you have left depending on your monthly plan. I'll go over that in a little bit. So you could do submit your subscription. For time purpose, I am going to do one that's already pulled in, so we don't have to wait that 2 minutes. So I pulled this first one in from, and as you can see, in progress and transcribe already. This first one was from, I believe it's from one of the YouTube videos, and I could delete any of my projects right here. Let's say I could delete, okay. And then I could go in and edit and double click on here. And once I double click, it's gonna bring me into my draft transcript. So it's importing all the images, it's importing, and it has a little preview of my YouTube this is not my YouTube video, it's actually a designer of the YouTube video that I want to import. As you can see how neat that is. All this down here, it takes the major points in the video, and it takes a guess. And of course, if you don't like it in here, anything, you could always click on it, and you could simply just delete the picture, or you have all your options over here. You could, once you hover over, you could see right here. And if I look down, let's see, let me just delete that. And if I look down here and I see, I could edit here, I could remove out and check over for my grammar, my typos. Do I need, you know? And let's say, for example, this is too much text. I want to bring in a screenshot. And this part I really, really appreciate is, and you can see the time right here. I could highlight, and then it would go right to that video moment and bring in that screenshot. So I would simply click on the image.
Let's see. In this video, I'm going to show you a feature called dynamic transcripts.
You could review over here, so you can break your text apart and just delete this. So once you're happy with that, you know, looking over it, you scroll down and save. I always save just in case. And then I could simply select next. And I see my display. Step three is choosing a nice template to put this information in. And I'll choose vanilla. So you select next. I'll keep the name. And then here's my template. Save. And then next. Okay. So once I click next, it's going to take me to the wonderful editor where I could make simple changes, global changes, add in images, put in anything, just polish it up. You just scroll down, you see all the right here. And what's wonderful about this is that I could actually select any of my screenshot, and it actually takes me, when I save it, it actually takes me to the opens up the YouTube video. So if I scroll down, I could go in here and I could edit, you know, the paragraph. I could take elements here. You can do table content, new articles, your layout. You can make, you know, two columns, right? You could do the shadows, distance, lighter. See how it adds a shadow. So you could blur things out. Like maybe you had information that you didn't want people to see. You could blur it out. I think that's a wonderful feature. You're just doing a tutorial and it has your personal information. You could change the theme. So let's say if I want to change it to a dark theme, one click of a mouse, there you go. Change it to that theme. To me, it's a little bit too dark, not enough contrast. How about this orange, a nice pop of orange? And there you go. You can go here. I mean, endless, like colors, images. You can remove your background. So I'm going to show you, let's see, let's publish this. You can save and then publish. Let's see. And the choices you have is PDF, mobile Kindle, EPUB, HTML. And let's export this. And it's generating a PDF. And next I'm going to show you after it does this PDF. I'm actually going to take this URL here. Let me just go through so you can see it's 120 pages. Isn't that awesome? So I'm going to take this URL and I'm going to create a flipbook. This is another feature that I absolutely love, and I think that will be very engaging on my websites. Let's see. Let's go up here back to the main. So I'm back into the main dashboard once again. And if you want to see over here's the transcript, you want to go back, you could duplicate your projects again. And I'm going to create new project and I'm going to create a flipbook. So a flipbook is a PDF that's simply displayed like a book where you could go back and forward. And I think that makes a world of difference. It makes it more engaging. You see that on Amazon. So if you simply go here and then you could create, you know, my first book, my first flipbook. And put in the link to your PDF, which is the one that I just created, and next. And it's importing in the pages, and it gives you, right here you see this screen, take your URL here, Control C, and your flipbook is available anytime on your project tab, just in case if you miss copying this. And what's great is that you could take this URL and directly embed it right into your Facebook post, and you have your PDF, you could put it in your HTML. So let's take a look and see how that looks like. I'm gonna paste the URL of the flipbook that I just created. And it makes such a difference. It's much more interactive. See all your screenshots. Absolutely love this. This is just wonderful. So let's talk about pricing. Let's go into pricing. So for pricing, for Designrr, you have a $39 monthly pricing where you only have one user and you got 200 design covers. You got these features here. I would recommend, you know, stepping it up and going to the monthly. I think this one is good because you got the transcription hour. Like I said, the caption is very good for videos, especially if you work with website, you have like a automatic transcript. Before on websites, we would literally sit there, like a person would sit there and type out and listen to the video and hit stop and transcribe. That would save you a lot of money. Then you could also go in and edit as well. So you have 200 plus design covers. It's almost like having a designer on your, you know, on your hand. You don't have to hire a freelancer, which is could cost a lot of money. I myself am a designer, so I know that this tool is very valuable in saving time. I know what it takes to just create things from scratch. This just has it all inside the software, the templates, the fonts, everything could be changed globally. You make a mistake, you could duplicate. It's a very smart way of working and producing your books. And right here, this one has the flipbook generator. So I really like this one because of that feature. You can export from using any website, the code, Facebook, get started, and you also have a money back if you find that this is not the right tool for you. But I think it's well worth it. I mean, you could spend a lot of money on contractors and where work designers, you know, you got, you know, and then you have to buy like stock images, and that is costly too. So where I work, you know, you have the stock image, you got your design, you have like probably, this would take, reduce the work of probably three people, you know. The designer and the templates, the image, everything's there. The transcript, you know, you don't need another person to sit and do that. Especially with your 30-day, you got 7-day trial. I think you just can't beat this tool. To me, I would highly recommend that. It's packed with features. You can go on the website and you could look down here, eBooks, Flipbooks, video, transcript, read more about it, the blog. So let me know what you think. Leave your comments below and let me know if you any other tools you like me to review. I absolutely love doing this. I love discovering these new applications and just demoing it. So anyway, I hope you have a blessed day, and let me know if you try out Designrr. Have a great day. Bye-bye.